गुड इवनिंग, गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन. वी वेलकम ऑल आवर पार्टिसिपेंट्स फॉर द आफ्टरनून सेशन. द सेशन विल बी स्टार्टेड एट 3 o'clock. थैंक यू. Good afternoon, Muniswamy sir.
Hello.
Sir, good afternoon, sir.
Madam, my voice is audible?
Yes, sir, it's audible, sir. Yes, sir, it's audible, sir.
Just a moment, madam, your voice, I'm unable to.
Sir?
Sir, am I audible?
Hello.
Hello, sir. Good afternoon, sir.
Hello.
Hello, sir.
Sushma, can you check with the computer?
Hello.
Sir. Sir. Yes, ma'am. I'll check, ma'am. It's audible for us, ma'am, clearly.
Yeah, I'll call the
chair. Okay, ma'am.
ఇప్పుడు ఒకసారి మాట్లాడండి మేడం.
Am I audible now, sir?
Good afternoon, sir. Can you hear me? Hello, sir. Hello, sir.
सर अदरवाइज मेरो
हाँ जी ओके
हेलो
सर यूट्यूब स्टार्ट कर रहा हूँ ना ऑफ कर देता हूँ
हाँ मैडम
हेलो
सर यू आर ऑडिबल
हेलो
हेलो गुड आफ्टरनून मुनिस्वामी गारु
सर हेलो सर सर योर वॉइस इज ऑडिबल फॉर अस सर बट इट इज लिटिल वेरी लो
ల్యాప్టాప్ కూడా ఆన్ చేసి పెట్టించాను మేడం ల్యాప్టాప్ అయిపోతుంది నాకు బ్లూటూత్ అయితే ఆన్లో ఉంది
I request all the participants to be kindly please wait for 5 minutes there are few technical issues we'll be rectifying in 5 to 10 minutes సరే ఇప్పుడు మాట్లాడండి మీరు చూద్దాం
మేడం సార్ ఐ థింక్ సార్ లెఫ్ట్ ద మీట్ మ్యామ్
ఐ సెడ్ సార్ టు లాగ్ అవుట్ అండ్ అగైన్ రీజాయిన్ ప్లీజ్ ఎవ్రీబడి Please be patient in 5 to 10 minutes we are going to start our webinar second session
హలో మేడం గారు.
సార్ గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్.
హలో
హలో సార్ గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్. యు ఆర్ ఆడిబుల్ టు అస్.
జస్ట్ ఎ మోమెంట్. Okay, ma'am.
Yeah. Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, good afternoon, ma'am.
Shall we start our second session of today's webinar, sir?
Yes.
Professor Vijayaratna madam is talking to you, sir. Please.
Okay,
ma'am. Good afternoon, madam.
Good afternoon, madam.
Sir, let us start our session. I welcome all the delegates. Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
So, for the second session of today's webinar, we have Professor B. Muniswamy Garu, Honorary Director, Population Research Center and Head Department of Statistics, Andhra University, a renowned researcher and a good speaker, and he is a best friend of mine. And if you have a glance on his CV, it takes a lot of time to read me. But first of all, before going into the CV, I would like introduction of the speaker. I would like to congratulate Professor B. Muniswamy sir on this platform in front of Professor J. Vijayaratna madam, honorary professor of AU College of Pharmaceutical Sciences, Andhra University. Madam sir has got today an award from Social Phase Research Network Best Researcher Award.
Congratulations, Muniswamy.
Let's congratulate Muniswamy. Today in the morning only, sir has got this award for his efforts in the Population Research Center.
Very good.
Congratulations, sir.
Thank you, madam. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. So, Professor Muniswamy, sir, we received a first prize and a cash award of 1 lakh as head department of statistics towards the best performance in NAC third cycle peer team visit in 2016, and received the best researcher award in IJIEMR Elsevier SSRN Research Award through International Journal for Innovative Engineering and Management Research, Elsevier SSRN in 2021, today that is. And sir has a lot of professional experience in his credit. So, University Nodal Officer for All India Survey on Higher Education, New Delhi, and served as and serving as the Chief Warden of AU Research Scholars Hostel, which is a typical job, and served as a Chairman, PG Board of Studies, Deputy Coordinator, UGC SAP DRS First Phase, Co-Convener and Research Forum Committee Member, and Central Purchasing Committee Member, Member, AU Annual Report Committee, Warden to the Science College Hostels, so on and so many administrative positions sir has served since 15 years. And he has a project in his credit, the awareness of health and nutrition of adolescent in ITDA residential schools of Visakhapatnam district funding agency UNICEF from the 30th July to 2019. So he is working on some consultancy on statistical consultant to the state nodal office ACHI Guntur Andhra Pradesh for All India Survey on Higher Education Consultancy Service to the Amaravati Metropolitan Region Development Authority, Vijayawada, for projection of population in Amaravati, capital city. So for his credit, he has published 35 papers, 15 years of teaching experience, research sciences studies conducted, 25 communicated international papers, recently 2 papers, seminars presented, 24 seminars and conferences attended, 5 workshops attended, 12 guest lectures delivered, 39. You see the beauty of this number 39. Sir is a renowned speaker, so let us take a step forward to grab the knowledge from sir to update ourselves in biostatistics, which is a core research of our pharmaceutical sciences. Without biostatistics, we cannot submit a PhD thesis. So that importance of biostatistics, led by Professor B. Munuswamy garu to this level, and number of MPhils guided 2, number of PhDs guided 9, and MSc projects 12, seminars organized 2, training programs and workshops organized 7, webinars organized 3. So with this brief introduction, I would like to invite our today's session speaker, Professor B. Munuswamy garu, and I hand over to you, sir.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much. First of all, I would like to say thank you for giving an opportunity to share my knowledge to the students and researchers. So today's my topic is biostatistics. So generally we know that biostatistics is a branch of statistics which deals with the data related to medical science, public health, medical research, epidemiology, pharmaceutical sciences, and so on. What not? Not only in the biological studies. So the statistical applications are used in all the disciplines, even in social science research, even in linguistics also. So in simpler words, when we apply statistics in biological science, so it is called biostatistics. We all know that healthcare industry is the largest sector in India, which contains of hospitals, pharmaceuticals, diagnostics, telemedicine, medical tourism, and so on. So the health sector is very vast. So in all the fields, the people are, or the scientists are applying statistical tools and techniques. So in this talk, I will explain a few statistical applications in the field of pharmaceutical and other health services. Right. So before going to the talk, so let us discuss a little significance. Like you see where our statistical applications are directly applying. Suppose you see a local PHC, so primary health centers, want to know the proportion of people affected by an outbreak of certain disease, and to find out the causes behind it, and to prevent further situations. And one more thing is, so during a clinical trial, there are many phases for drug or device development. And many question is, But here my question is, how will they know whether the trial is going good or bad? Suppose anyone prepared a new drug. Okay, so the drug is good or bad. How can we know? Right. So based on the statistical techniques, so previous readings or present readings, so we can compare by applying statistical techniques. So in a pharmaceutical company.
Sorry to disturb you, sir. Are you sharing any PPT?
Yeah, ma'am. I will share.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, just 2 minutes.
Okay, the introduction part. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Right, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, I will share my PPT.
Sure, sir.
Yeah. So in a pharmaceutical company, they want to know the disclosure rate, dissolution rate of a particular tablet, and to know whether it satisfies the desired rate or not. So dissolution of tablet, whether it is desired rate or not. So suppose we want to calculate, we use statistical application. So similarly, they want to know the mean weight of a tablet to compare with other batches. So now my question is, how will they do the analysis? Right, so I will share my PPT.
I request all the participants to sit with your system, please. Sir, please go ahead.
Screen is visible, sir.
Ma'am, my slide is shared.
Yes, sir. It's shared, sir.
Yeah, ma'am. Okay, ma'am. Right. So now I am concentrating more handling the data and some brief theoretical concepts. So first of all, in this biostatistics, right? So I will cover descriptive statistics, correlation analysis, regression analysis, t-test, f-test, analysis of variance, and chi-square tests. These are all some basics of statistical tests. Suppose if you want to publish any paper or your thesis, right? Definitely you are going to apply from descriptive statistics to analysis of variance techniques, right? So the statistics has major two concepts. One is descriptive statistics and the other one is inferential statistics. So descriptive statistics means it gives numerical and graphical procedures to summarize a collection of data. So in a clear and understandable way. Suppose you take any one variable, for example, body mass index. So that body mass index, suppose you apply the descriptive statistics, right? We can estimate the variable characteristic. What is the minimum BMI? What is the maximum? Right? What is its average? Okay, so is there any skewness of your data, whether our statistical properties are satisfying or not? So these, so any one, those who are doing data analysis, the first and foremost, we have to run the descriptive statistics, right? If the observations are not follows normal distribution, what will happen? Okay, so first and foremost, we observe the graphical representation, if the data is follows a normal distribution or not. The second one is inferential statistics. So inferential statistics provides procedures to draw inferences about a population from a sample. Okay, suppose generally the people are, so many research are doing research, but that research should be generalized. Right, but how we evaluate the generalization? For example, you see, we know that the heartbeat pulse rate per minute is 72. Okay. But where it beats 72? Right, in Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, or USA, London, UK. So you see, a common healthy man heartbeat pulse rate per minute is 72. suppose you see in our country, right, we have more than 139 crores population is there, but no one can measure each and every individual's heartbeat pulse rate. So we take an sample. Okay, so based on the sample results, we are generalizing as a whole. So the purpose of statistical techniques is what? Need not to test each and every individuals, each and every individuals of the data, just to observe a sample of observations. So that sample characteristics is equal to the population characteristic. So that's why we are applying statistical tools and techniques. So the again, this inferential statistics is classified into two parts. One is theory of estimation, and the second one is testing of hypothesis. So in my lecture, I will cover a testing of hypothesis. Right. So this is briefly statistics, descriptive and inferential statistics. Okay. Right. So what is the data? Right. Right. Now you see nowadays we are generating a lots of data every day. Okay. But statistical data. But all the data is not a statistical data. Okay. So generally data are the first thing which pops out on the head when we talk about any kind of analysis. Since we are dealing with data for analysis, so we should know the basic concept of it. Generally, we have four types of data types are there. So without data types, we don't know which statistical techniques to apply. So our statistical techniques are depending on, based on types of a data. Okay, so here you see, so generally we have the data types. It is categorical and numerical. That means generally we call it as a qualitative data and quantitative data. Right. So for qualitative data, in the sense there is no measure. Okay. For example, you see IQ levels or honesty or beauty. Okay. There is no any particular measure, but the data have some categories. So IQ level, first grade, second grade, third. Okay. Honesty. Okay. For example, beauty have some categories, categorical data. Same time, the data may ordinal data. Ordinal data in the sense preferences, good, better, worst. Suppose I'm showing one product, right? That product is, you are satisfied or not satisfied. So it is a categorical data type. But here our statistical analysis is differ from a nominal and ordinal. Okay, so later I will discuss one by one. So here, in the case of numerical data, again the numerical data are classified into two, that is interval data and ratio data. So interval data means it is a discrete and continuous data. For example, ratio data, for example, you see blood pressure, right? Systolic and diastolic. So the value is in a ratio. So at that time, what type of statistical analysis we have to apply? Okay. So in this data.
Sir?
Variable values are names. That means labels. For example, gender. Gender is male and female or transgender. Okay, so here, what type of statistics? So variable values are only 1 and 2. That means male or female. What type of statistical applications we have to apply? So in the same case, ordinal scale, right? So variable values are preferences. So you see in this image, hot, hotter, hottest. So here we can apply some relational operators. So in the nominal scale data, it is not possible to apply arithmetic and logical operators. Okay, for example, you see the disease, whether it is a positive or negative, right? So here there is no meaning of positive is greater than negative or negative is less than positive. Okay, but here the dose level, dose 1, dose 2, dose 3, for example, mg 10 mg, right, 15 mg or 20 mg have some measurements, but there is no measurement in nominal scale. So in the ordinal scale is data is preferable, but in the interval scale, for example, you take age is measured is, for example, 20 25 21, that type of data is called it as interval scale. But ratio scale, so out of 24 hours, how many hours you are sleeping? So 8 by 24, right, 9 by 24, for that type of data, right, what type of statistical applications we are applying. So now you see here, so in the nominal case, in the sense only it is a figurative labeling scheme, male or female. For this type of data, we apply generally percentages, mode, chi-square and binomial test. So simple, I will explain how the categorical data is converted into a statistics mod. Okay, let us see here. Is it visible?
Yes, sir, it's visible, sir.
Yeah. Now you see, so my question is here, how we analyze the data in the form of a qualitative data. Here, how many balls are there?
Any 10 balls.
Interact it. 10 balls. How many balls. Colors?
Four colors.
Four colors. What are those?
Blue, red, yellow, green, orange.
Blue, red,
yellow,
orange.
One more color is also there. What is that?
Blue, red, long. Green, sir.
Green. But is there any numbers?
No. Yes, sir.
No. But we can prepare a frequency table. So if the data is in a form of a quality, but can you say that quality wise, not quantity, quality wise, blue is greater than red?
Quality,
not quantity. Okay. I'm not talking about balls. Here four balls, here three balls. No. Quality wise?
No, sir.
No. So male and female, gender is also?
No.
Okay. So for this type of data, you see how I am preparing a statistical tests. So here you see, you prepare a frequency table. Frequency table. So how many blue balls are there?
Four.
Yeah, blue balls are
four,
and red balls are three. Then each
one,
right? So here you see, so what type of statistics I can perform, then you go for frequency tables. So this is a frequency. Now you take it percentages. So how we take percentage?
Total,
right? Yes. So component value, 4 divided by 10.
Yes, sir.
4 divided by 10 into 100.
100.
So its percentage is
40%.
Right? After writing a formula, just to drag, automatically it types. So you see, so red is 30%, this is yellow is 10, this is orange is 10, green is 10. So the total is 100%.
100%.
So this is a qualitative data. How can we represent in a tabular form, in a statistical way? So same this we can represent in a graphical representation. Okay, you see here insert, then you take, suppose, pie chart.
Yes,
so if the data is in a frequencies or categories, You see, blue, red, yellow, orange, green categories are there. What type of data you go for? Pie chart, not histogram. Okay, so charts are depending on type of a scale. Okay, right. Okay. So insert. Just you see. So this is graphical representation. So now what I am discussing, this is descriptive statistics.
Yes, sir.
It describes about your data. So that simple data, how we describe. Okay. So now this is also, then you can describe the labels. Just to click any one of the right part here, the right click. Okay. Add
labels.
Okay. Right click, or at a time also we can take it. Okay. So percentage also we can draw. Add labels. Same percentage is also. Right, in the format here, percentages. Meanwhile, okay, percentage. So this is a simple descriptive statistics for nominal data. If the data is in names, but what about the ordinal data? Means it is rankings of data. If the data is in a form of a rank. So here, in the case of nominal data, if you want to apply descriptive statistics are mean, median, mode, geometric mean, harmonic mean. Among all these five, simply we call it as average. So average means what? Average is a single value. That single value represents the significance of the data. The significance of the data. Okay, so that's why mean, median, mode, geometric, harmonic mean, simply we call it as average. But when we apply mean, median, and mode, okay, suppose if the data is in a form of a nominal case, you apply mode. Okay, so in this case, the color, mode, what is the formula of mode? Generally, which frequency value is high? So in this color, blue value is very high, percentage or frequency. So in this case, the mode of color is blue. Okay, so here the descriptive statistics, you can apply mode. Okay, but when we apply median, right, the median means if the data you can arrange in a systematic order, either minimum to maximum or maximum to minimum, you pick up the middle one. But why we apply median, anyone knows? Already mean is also there, but generally we are applying median. Okay, right. So if in your data have any outliers, suppose I insist, suppose you see in my data, the heartbeat pulse rate is, okay, 72, 73, again 72, 74, right? This is, right? Suppose one patient heartbeat pulse rate is only, right, 55. Let us assume that. Let us see that. So what is the average of this data? Okay, it is very simple. Just a moment, I will take this data is in right. So this is the heartbeat pulse rate. Just simple, I'm taking here the average, right? So here equal to simple, the formula is average, just to drag it. Okay, the average is 70.54. okay, suppose you see I'm deleting this 55. Just to look into this, I am deleting this 55. So what is your average now?
73.1.
Previously, how it is? 70. So due to a single value, okay, so your data is drastic changing. Okay, simple, you see, suppose a wrong entry data, suppose the data is 72, okay, I type it as 27, what will happen? You see the mean, what is its mean?
66.
So even a single data, single observation you change, right, it drastically changing. Okay, so my question is, what if, suppose if really this heartbeat pulse rate is 72 or 27, suppose one doctor approached me, sir, this is my statistics data, you perform arithmetic mean. So suppose I performed, the arithmetic mean is, the average is 66. Okay, so the doctor said that, sir, your answer is wrong. Wrong in the sense, actually the heartbeat pulse rate, the majority is 76. Okay, but the answer is lies between, in between, but your answer is 66.5. But I said this is a outlier. But how can I remove? I said simply you remove the data. Okay, the doctor said, who are you to remove? Actually, original data is this. Okay, but how can you remove? Okay, so it's not possible to remove the data. So in that case, I said, sir, you perform median. Okay, so median in the sense what? So middle value we are picking up. Okay, so just you see, what is the answer here? What is the minimum value here? 27. The next minimum value is 72. How many times?
Three times.
Next
73.
Then
74.
So how many values? Six. One more value is also there. 76. So what is the median here for all these values?
72.
So 72. This is your answer. You see, 72 is your answer. So you can change any value. Now I am changing 27 as 47. What is your answer?
72.
76 is changing, my heartbeat pulse rate is 86. So what is your answer?
72.
So that means what? When we apply median, suppose if you want to include any outliers in your data, also we can apply the median of median application. So this is simply, okay? So without any outliers, simply we go for average. That means this is mean, simply mean. But this is median. Okay, suppose in the mean, as it is, you see, I am performing here equal to average of this data. You see, I am performing average of this horizontal data. The mean is 70.85. Okay, but average of this vertical data, the mean is 73. Okay, so due to these two outliers, the answer is different. But whereas this is what? Both are means. But you take this data median, the answer is same, here 72. Same in the sense, it's nearer to this mean. Okay, so this is how we apply arithmetic, what is that, mean, median, and mode. Okay, so generally, mean, median is used for interval data. Okay, direct heartbeat pulse rate, ages. Okay, so this is simply the data types, nominal, ordinal, interval, and ratio. If variable values are names, that means labels, you go for mode. If the variable values are ordinal scale, you go for median. If the variable values are interval scale, that means discrete and continuous. Direct values, for example, age, 20, 21, 22, like that type of data, you go for interval data. If the data is in ratio scale, it's better to apply harmonic mean and geometric mean. Its formula is also reciprocal. Okay. So this is simply a data types, but generally the researchers are doing without data types, but always people are performing arithmetic mean. Suppose you see in any news or magazines, any published information, people are discussing about the average heartbeat pulse rate. okay, average blood pressure, right, average profits, everything is in average we are discussing. So that's why I explained a brief descriptive statistics. Next we go for, if the data is in nominal, so we go for percentages, just in the balls count, percentages, mode. Mode means which color. So blue color is our mode. So chi-square test is also there. This is inferential statistics, chi-square test. Suppose two categories you take it, right? Two categories, okay? Suppose area and type of a disease. So rural and urban, okay? The dengue persons affected or not affected, you take it. So is there any area impact on the disease? So at that time we go for chi-square test. So area is also variable values are what? Rural and urban. So disease, right? Affected or not affected. Here both the two variables, if you want to test, we go for inferential statistics, that is chi-square test, that data variable values are nominal. Same in the case of binomial test. Suppose whenever we go to the bank, state bank, are you satisfied with the state bank services? Right, in the month of first week? So the bank is very busy. So in our branch, Andhra University branch, so always the branch is very busy. So whether you satisfied or not their services. So only variable values are two cases. Suppose if you want to estimate probability of satisfaction, so you go for binomial distribution. Okay, right. So if the data is in ordinal, right, that means in the you can apply percentile, median, rank order, correlation. But in the case of nominal scale type of data, it is not possible to apply arithmetic and logical operators. But in the case of ordinal scale, you can apply some relational operators. So hot is less than hottest. Hotter is also less than hottest. We can apply some relational operators. But in the case of interval scale, you can apply arithmetical operators. That means mean, sum of observations by number of observations. So you can apply multiplications, divisions, subtractions in this scale, interval data. But there it is not possible in nominal scale data. So here the statistical applications are range, mean, standard deviation, correlation, t-test, ANOVA. Actually, a number of statistical applications are there, but due to space constraints, I'm giving a limited statistical applications. So this is geometric mean and coefficient of variation. Okay, harmonic means. So this is interval ratio type of data. So out of 7 feet, what is its height? Okay, so 6.6 by 7, right? So its height is 4.5 by 7. So what that type of data, you can apply these type of statistics. Right, so statistics two types already given. This is descriptive and inferential. If it is nominal data, you go for percentages mode. If it is inferential, chi-square and binomial. Same ordinal, this type. So interval, descriptive and inferential. Ratio, okay, right. Let us see. So now you see this is one food and nutrition data, right? I did this analysis. So individual energy nutrient intake statistics. So here the variable sports is type is a one variable, gender is one variable, five types of sports are there, males and females. So they given, so food and nutrition department, they prepared one drink. That drink contains, right, energy, protein, fat, CHO, CA, iron, vitamin, cholesterol. So if we consume the drink, it gives this type of data sets. Okay, but in this here, what are the variables and what are the factors? Anybody, can you say how many variables and how many factors are here?
Eight variables, sir.
40 variables, sir.
40? No, you see?
8-way reverse. So
yeah, so variables are how much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. These are all the variables. These variable values, how it is, energy is measured in kilocalories. So here it has some measure. Protein is also measured in grams. Fat is also measured in grams. So this is which type of data? This is interval data. Okay. Mm-hmm. But sports type is which type of data? Coco, running, volleyball, this is nominal.
Nominal.
Gender is also nominal. Right? Why this value is 2912 and this value 3250? Why the values are differ? Okay. Maybe this value is depending on type of sports. This value is depending on gender. So we can estimate, is there any significant difference between the male energy and female energy? Right. How can you test the significance difference between these two groups, male energy and female energy? So we have some statistical tests. Generally, people are doing what? Male mean energy, female mean energy. But always mean, that means average, cannot give full information. So that's why we have to invite inferential statistics. Right, so this is one type of data, right? So fine, actually I analyzed the data and the results given to the food and nutrition department. They keenly observed. They said, sir, your data analysis entire were wrong. But I said, whatever you given the data, right, just simply I entered the data in SPSS and carried the analysis. Okay, what? Here, they missed some factors. What is missing here? We are performing what? A COCO average, COCO energy mean, volleyball energy mean, hockey energy mean, running energy mean, basketball. Same male energy, female energy I am running. But it gives some wrong information. Why? So energy means to whom? Male or female is there, but some variable is missed. What is missed? Age is missed here. You see, the sports, the energy level is depending on what? Age is also. So under 11, the sports is under 11, under 15, under 21, under 30. So you have to categorize, you have to take one more factor, that is age. So they have not classified this energy levels in a different age groups. That's why the data says one direction, your theory says another direction. There is no coordination between data and theory. That's why before doing analysis, before preparing of any questionnaire, right, at least you have to approach your known statistician, what variable should consider in my experiment. But really here, the age factor is also there, but they have not taken. So I said, but then they taken, they classified the data according to the years, then the analysis were good, they said. So next you see one more data. So this is physical education statistics. The first one is gym exercise. The second one is yoga exercise. Okay. So I recorded the heartbeat pulse rate. So control group means without exercise, gym group, yoga group. I recorded males and females heartbeat pulse rate. Okay, generally, which one is better, yoga or gym?
Gym, sir.
Yoga, why?
Gym, sir.
But nowadays, yoga is famous, isn't it? Everyone doing yoga. We are celebrating international yoga. Our Modi ji, right, and Jagan, all are all participating in yoga day. That's why, can you say that yoga is popular?
No.
So that's why what?
Both are own advantages and disadvantages.
So statistics. So my question is what here? Statistics won't believe name and fame. Name and fame. It believes only numerical facts and figures. Numerical facts and figures. Whatever you collected the data, you see, control group means without exercise, heartbeat pulse rate. Gym exercise, heartbeat pulse rate. Yoga exercise, heartbeat pulse rate. Suppose you see the data, these three types of data. Which one is better? Can you say? Can you say which one is better?
Yoga, sir.
How you say?
Based on the data observations, are there 1,000, 1 lakh observations,
isn't it? That's why you have to apply some statistical tools to analyze the data. Okay, so what are that statistical tools? But here the variables are what? Gender is a variable, but its values are how it is? Nominal case, male and female. Group A, it is a measurable. Heartbeat pulse rate is measured, is right, pulse. Group A, B, C is also same measure. But how can we analyze? Let us see. Okay, so here is also. So secondhand smoke cancer data. Right, this data also I analyzed. So just you see the groups. So this is the group. This is the grade. Right, the stage may be mild, severe, moderate. Then gender, male, female. Habit, either a cigarette, smokeless tobacco, chutta. But tail length is a interval data. Age is also interval data. But habit, nominal. Gender, nominal. But grade, which type of data? Grade. Mild, severe, moderate. Ordinal data. Yeah, data is in a form of order. Ordinal data this is. So for this type of data, how can we analyze, how we apply the statistical tools and techniques? So that is my intention. So you see the fields of application of statistics. So in all the field, the statistics is applying, right? Now, simple, I will discuss a descriptive statistics. Okay, why we invite, right? Descriptive statistics are of two. One is measure of central tendency. The another one is measures of dispersion. Okay, but generally people are talking about average, but not standard deviation. Okay, if a standard deviation is not applying, what will happen? Just have my intention is this. Suppose you see, okay, the average of a score X is 20. The average of score Y is 20. I will give a general example, right? Suppose two players played two innings in the cricket. So both are got 20-20. Can we give the man of the series to whom? Average X is 20, average Y is 20. So both are?
It's same.
Same. Isn't it? Yeah. Yes, suppose a response of a patient score, response of patient score, right? Both are same. Now you see the data, score of X and score of Y. Score of X total is 100. The mean is 20. Score of a total is 100. The mean is 20. Now, 20. Which means X or Y? May I give man of the series both?
No, sir.
To we need to go for. We have to give.
We need to go for median or mode, sir.
Why, sir?
No. So my question is here. So to describe your analysis not only for average but also you invite measure of dispersion. Okay, suppose you see you perform the average of x and y, both are 20-20, you said both series are same. No, absolutely. You see x is better performance than y. Why? WHY, why x is performance better than y? So you observe the in the x variable values, all are nearer to mean. You see, nearer to mean, but the score y, the disturbance is very large. You see, even though totally same, mean is same, but here one value is 10 and one value is 30. So player x is a consistent player, player y is not a consistent player. Suppose you find out the range of x. How we find out the range? Maximum value minus minimum value. What is the maximum value here? 22. Okay, so the minimum is 18. 22 minus 18?
4.
So the range is 4, x of range is 4. But what about the range of y?
30 minus 10, sir. 20.
20. So the range is very high. Okay, that means what? Okay, which measure of dispersion value is minimum, that is better. How you take a decision, a statistical decision you take. So which measure of dispersion value is minimum, that is better performance. Okay, so that is what? Range of x is 4, that's why x is better. But range is a crude measure. In between 18 to 22, you change any value, the answer won't reflect. Same again like median. Suppose you see 30 to 10, in between you can change any value. Suppose I'm 15, I'm changing as 20, the answer is same. Okay, that's why range is won't give perfect results. That's why we go for standard deviation. Okay, so standard deviation. How we take a standard deviation? So summation of x minus x bar, okay, whole square by, yeah. So this is a standard deviation or variance. You can take both, right? So now I performed here standard deviation. Now without this x and y data also, just to observe these four, this is a descriptive statistics. These four, the average of x is 20, the average of y is 20, but the standard deviation x is 1.56, the standard deviation of y is 7.06. So to whom now we give man of the series, x or y?
X, sir.
Yeah, x, there is no tie, right? Based on the performance of individual values, right? Yes, so now I am showing one more data set. Now you see, now you are an analyst to analyze the data. Just crude, you observe the range. Which one is better?
Z, sir.
Yeah, Z is better. For Y means all the values are nearer to the arithmetic mean, you observe. Right? Yes. The mean is 20 average, but all the values are more or less nearer to 20. But in the case of Y series, drastic change is there. Okay, so here is also little bit more. So player Z is better performance than X, but X is better performance than Y. Same in the case of different types of drugs. Three drugs you take it, drug X, drug Y, drug Z, the performance of a drug. So which drug performance is better? So now we go for the performance of Z is better than X and Y, even though the averages are same. Now this is how we take a decision. This decision is very, very important. Right. Now I'm showing one more data set. Can you say which group is better performance? Right. With visual aid, it is not possible. So compulsory, we have to apply some statistical tools and techniques. We have one more test is there, powerful test, that is coefficient of variation. Efficient, but here you see how much percentage y is efficient than x. how much of percentage Z is efficient than X and Y, it's not there. But in the case of you apply coefficient of variation test, it is very simple formula. Standard deviation by mean into 100. So we can say that which series performance is better. Now, based on the heartbeat pulse rate, without exercise person's heartbeats are better, or gym exercise heartbeat pulse rates are better, or yoga is better based on the observed data sets. So you see, this is the analysis. Group A total and its mean and its standard deviation and its coefficient of variation. How if I find coefficient of variation? So standard deviation by mean into 100, so you get 7.69, 6.96, 6.61, right? So among all these three groups, need not to see the raw data, just to observe these data. This is a descriptive statistics. In this descriptive statistics, which coefficient of variation in that series is better performance than another series. So here group C means yoga is better performance than gym and control group. Why? The variation is minimum. The percentage is only 6.61 percentage is there. So we have to give the generalizes. Yoga is better performance than gym exercise. Gym exercise is better performance than control group. So this is how we take a decision. So this is simply a descriptive statistics. So descriptive statistics means it describes of your variable. Okay, characteristics of a variable it describes. So the descriptive statistics compulsory you require minimum value, range, mean, standard deviation. Or if you require coefficient of variation. Okay, so generally descriptive statistics covers measure of center tendency, measure of dispersion, measure of shapes. Skewness is also there. Measure of shapes. These three are covered under descriptive statistics. Right. Now descriptive statistics is just now I completed. So any queries regarding descriptive statistics, just to ask. Only in descriptive statistics.
No, sir, everything is clear.
Yeah. Okay. Right. So this is a descriptive statistics. Now I am moving relationship, but here control group, gym, yoga, three variables are independent. Three variables are independent. So again, variables are classified independent or dependent. So variable types are four: nominal, ordinal, interval, and ratio. Type to type, our statistical applications are different. Okay, so in the descriptive statistics, we go for measure of center tendency, measure of dispersion, measure of shapes. But in inferential statistics, we go for correlation, regression, t-test, analysis of variance test. So in the correlation analysis, you see. So correlation analysis means to study the relationship between the two variables. But one variable is independent, the another variable is dependent. For example, you see dose and response. If dose is increased, what about the response? Response is static, or decrease or increase. So that two relationships, how it is? That relationship may be low, moderate, or high. Okay, so generally correlation analysis deals with two D's. D. One D is for direction. Another D is for degree. Direction in the sense, the relationship of two variables, whether the two variables are positive, in the sense one variable is increasing, another variable is also increasing. Suppose dose is increasing, your response is also increasing. Okay, so this is positive correlation, but a negative correlation in the sense one is increasing, another one is decreasing. Suppose dose is increasing, response is decreasing. So both are opposite direction. So in that sense, we go for negative correlation. But if there is no dose impact on the response, that means no relationship. That means both variables are independent. Okay, that means what? Again here, our inferential statistical applications are depending on type of a nature of a variable. If both variables are independent, right, clearly observe, both variables are independent, you go for t-test, student t-test. If one variable is independent, another variable is dependent, you go for correlation analysis. So this is, we call it as what? Bivariate analysis. So in the descriptive statistics, I discussed only univariate analysis, single variable description, right? So here is also single variable, right? Control group or your gym group or yoga group. So based on these three variables, which performance is better? I have not concentrated on the impact of variables. Okay, is there any relationship between group A, B, C? Right, I have not concentrated. Okay, right, but here in the case of correlation, we discuss. Okay, sometimes correlation does not mean causation. So this is a hen correlation. Suppose in the decades back, right, hens crow in the sense what? The rising of a sun. Okay, but really hen does not cause the sun to rise. So that means what? We have to identify right variables, dependent and independent variables. For example, you see, simple example I'm giving, daily example is income and expenditure. Which one is independent and which one is dependent?
Expenditure is dependent.
Expenditure is dependent. Income is independent. So generally we go for a correlation analysis. Okay. For example, your income and shoe size. Right? Suppose income is increasing, your shoe size is also may increase.
No, sir.
Isn't it? No. Right? So both are independent variables. Okay. So in the correlation analysis, right? So our, right, when I starting my lecture, I said all the numbers are not a statistical numbers. Right? So I will explain here just to observe these numbers. So one number is 0.2, 0.7, 0.9, minus 1.0, 0.8. So what are those? What are these numbers?
Positive and negative.
Right. Just it is a positive or negative fractional values. Right. Is there any meaning? Nothing, just it is a numbers. But if these numbers are statistical numbers, it speaks to you. How in the sense, you see, the correlation analysis, we have a one formula, it is denoted as R. Okay, so the relationship between X and Y, the correlation value is plus 0.70, it gives some information. So here, the statistical value speaks to you. How it speaks in the sense? Plus in the sense, it is a positive correlation. Positive correlation in the sense what? One variable is increasing tendency, another variable is also increasing. For example, you increase the dose, 1 mg, 2 mg, 3 mg, 5 mg, but the response is increasing. Okay, so it is a positive correlation. Here is also positive correlation, but here moderate positive correlation and this is high positive correlation. Okay, so this is negative but high correlation. Okay, so here what? Negative in the sense what? One variable is increasing, another variable is decreasing. Suppose you increase the dose, response is decreasing. So this is negatively relationship. But the degree is high correlated. Okay, so that's why our statistical values speaks to you. But how we analyze is important, right? Nowadays, right, anyone need not to memorize dozens of formulas, need not to bahead, right? We have a wonderful statistical packages. The simple package is Excel is enough. Up to one-way, two-way, three-way analysis of variance, you can perform correlation, regression, t-test, f-test, descriptive statistics. Suppose if you require advanced factor analysis, discriminant analysis, cluster analysis, right, spatial analysis, okay, so we go for SPSS packages, right? So let us see. So here, just simple, I will switch over from correlation and regression analysis, and I will explain our what is that SPSS package. So you draw the x values and y values, right? Scatter diagram. If the diagram points are like this, this is positive correlation, right? But this is also okay. You see, this is a negative relationship, right? So here two types. Without formula also, you can just by graphical representation, right, based on the direction whether it is negative or positive. So generally correlation analysis deals with two. One is direction, another one is degree. Direction in the sense what? You see, this is a positive, this is a direction. You observe this, all the values are scattered. So this is a scattered diagram. If scattered is less, the relationship is more. So the degree is high. Scattered is more, the degree is low. This is the degree based on the scatter plot. So direction in the sense, from left to right upward direction, it is positive. From left to right downward direction, it is negative relationship. So these two only we study in correlation analysis, but simple I will explain. Okay, you see, this is a one data set, right? Not this one, right? You see, if all the data points are in the same line, straight line, so this is perfect correlation. You see the data points 1 2 3 4 1, that means the unit of change is 1 1 1 1 1. Here the unit of change is 10 10 10 10 10, same unit of changes, the answer is perfect 1 plus 1. So this is opposite, this is increasing, this is decreasing, both are opposite direction. So that's why this is negative, answer is plus. Okay, right. Now I'm taking one more data set, but here is there any direction? No direction. Okay, so this is no correlation, right? I will give one more. This is the formula. Now you see the data set, temperature and water consumption. So what is its relationship? Can you say anybody? How the data points? Water and water consumption. What is its direction? Negative or positive?
Positive, sir.
Right. It is a positive. Why? In the sense, temperature is increasing. Water consumption is also increasing. So it is a positive correlation. So that means what? Direction is completed. Direction is positive. But what about the degree? If relationship is there, how much relationship? 20%, 30%, 80% or 90%? Okay, that should be known, right? See, I will explain this, okay, in Excel. And also I will introduce SPSS. You see, so I am taking one data set, right? I am pasting here. Right. So In Microsoft Excel, the correlation keyword is equal to CORREL, bracket open. Just simply you drag the data set, type and drag it. The data is A2 to A8. Okay, then comma, then B2 to B8. So just to place the enter. What is its correlation value? What is its answer?
0.96.
0.96. Okay, so that means whether what is its direction? What is its direction? The direction enti? Just tell me. Positive. Just to observe the sign, whether it is negative or positive. Its sign is positive. So it is a one variable is increasing, another variable is increasing. But how to coefficient of determination? Suppose in a case of a percentages, so we have to find out generally in statistical sense, it is denoted as R. So correlation is denoted as R. So now you find out the R square. You find out the R square. How we find out the R square? Right? The R square value is R value into again R. So 9.6 into 9.6. So what is its R value? Isn't it? This value. You multiply by 100. It is very simple technique. Right? So R value into R value, you multiply by 100. What is its value in the percentages?
92%.
That means what? Right? So it is, the correlation is 0.96. You correlation value into 100, it is 92% influence. So water consumption is, but here which one is independent and which one is dependent?
Temperature
is
independent.
Independent. Water consumption is
dependent.
Isn't it? So temperature is influenced on the water consumption is 92.7%. 92.7. Approximately you take it a 93. 7% is not accounted. Only 93% is accounted. But if any outlier in your data, you see, a single value you change, right? The answer drastically changing. Just to observe the answers of these two. Okay, now I'm changing here. Actually, the data is 92. But instead of 92, I typed as 29. See what will happen. So what is your answers? You see? 0.31 and your percentage is 9.37, only 9.3. But previously how it is 93%, right? So due to a single value, instead of 92, I typed as 29, right? Your entire analysis is wrong. That's why you observe, right? Those who are doing research, right? Even single value is also very, very, very important to do research analysis. Okay, so this is a correlation and correlation analysis. Just to see, I'm a control Z, I'm pressing. So previously it is 96% is there, its impact is 92% is impact is there. But due to a single value, drastically your answer is changing. So this is the importance of correlation analysis. Simple. The correlation analysis deals with only two, degree and direction, whether it is positive or negative, or if the correlation is there, whether the correlation is high correlation, moderate correlation, low correlation. High correlation in the sense the correlation value near to the 0.9, moderate in the sense nearer to the 0.5, low in the sense nearer to the 0.25. So this is the correlation analysis. Right. Now, how we determine of correlation analysis in the sense, suppose your correlation value is 0.8. So the correlation between X and Y, rows and response, temperature, water consumption, the relationship correlation is 0.8. But how we find out it's a percentage is you square it. 0.8 square, right? 0.8 square in the sense 0.64. You multiply by 100. So it is 64% relationship is there. So temperature influence on the water consumption is 64% is accounted. But the remaining 36% is not accounted. Okay. But how can we improve this 64 to 74 or 84 or 94? Maybe you can change the, you can increase the sample size. Right here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Only 7 days values are there. You take 30 days values. You observe it. Maybe your correlation impact may increase. Or you decrease the variation in your experiment. Maybe your correlation value may increase. So always the correlation value nearer to 1 is better. Okay, this indicates, right? So this is simply correlation analysis. Next, go for regression analysis. Actually, the regression analysis is used if you know the one variable value, then you can estimate the another variable value, the estimation purposes. Okay, suppose in this slide you see the temperature is 99. Suppose the up to this, the temperature is 105. So what is the water consumption? You estimate it. Okay. Suppose the temperature is 65. What is the water consumption? So that purpose we apply regression analysis. Simple, you see. Suppose X, I know that. This is dose. Dose is increasing. First dose is 0. Initial, the response is 3. Suppose 1, it is 5. 2, it is 7. Suppose 3. So but what about the Y value? Dose is 3, the response is what about?
3, 5, 7,
next?
9, sir.
Yeah, 9. Suppose if it is 4, what about?
11, sir.
Suppose if 50, what about the Y value? Right? So we can estimate, but it takes time. Okay. But up to you know this data, you can fit a regression model, you will get one model. That is, okay, y equal to, just you see, it is 50, it is 103, it is 123, it is 249, it's 1024, it is 2051. But how, if you know up to this five values, you fit in a mathematical model, you will get a one model. That model is this. What is that? Y equal to A plus BX. Y equal to A plus BX. So here A is 3, B is 2. How it's get in the sense, I will explain in Excel. Okay. Suppose you substitute here, X is 0. Substitute X values in this equation. First X is 0. 2 into 0. 0, 0 plus 3, 3. So y equal to 3. Substitute x equal to 1. 2 plus 3, 5. Substitute x equal to 2. 2 into 2, 4. 4 plus 3, 7. Like that. Substitute x equal to 50. 50 into 2, 100. 100 plus 3, 103. Okay. So that means what? If you know the one variable, then you can estimate the another variable. Suppose the response, the x value is 2000. What is the X? You can estimate it by fitting a lean model. Okay, but how I will fit a linear regression model? It is very simple in Microsoft Excel, you see, right? I will show in Excel only, right? So this is temperature and water consumption. Already correlation values are there. Okay, we have one technique, that is scatter plot. So insert here, you see scatter plot. Scatter plot is used to study the relationship between the two variables. Okay, first you select the data. Okay, click the scatter plot. Now I'm selecting the type here. This is simple. Insert in Excel, scatter. Click this button. You see, this is my plot. Okay, the direction is positive. Actually, my correlation is what? 0.96. Okay, but this correlation and regression analysis model, y equal to, right, a plus bx, how it gives? Simple. Just to click the point, any one point, right? Right click. Simple, you see, here, add trend line, one option is there. Add trend line. You click this button, right? Here, exponential, linear, logarithmic, polynomial, power curve, moving averages. So mine is, it is a linear model. But here, bottom of the dialog box, just to observe here, display equation on chart, display R square value. This is display, you see, it displays the model, right? Then display R square. You see, it is very simple. Right? So my mathematical model is what? So AX plus B or A plus BX, both one and the same. Okay, here 1.4512X minus 96.845. So R square is what? You correlation value into correlation value, you will get R square, simple. Okay, so this is your mathematical model. But why we fit a mathematical model? Regression? Tell me anyone, why we fit regression model?
To know the difference in two variables.
No. Why correlation and regression? So correlation gives only relationship between the two variables. It is negative or positive, or low correlation, moderate correlation, or high correlation. These two only covers the correlation. Okay, but regression analysis gives what? Estimation. Okay, suppose your correlation, your temperature is 105. Temperature is 105. What is your water consumption? Can you say?
By regression analysis, we can
estimate. Yeah, but definitely we can say that the water consumption may be more than 48, isn't it? Right? You see, observations are increasing 16, 20, 25, 48. But I'm sure that the value is more than 48. But exact value we don't know. Okay, but how we estimate this? Right? So up to we know these seven values. Okay. So these seven values, what can we do? You fit a linear regression model. How we fit linear regression model? First to select the data, click insert, then go to scatter plot. This is scatter plot. Right? You click any one of the point, right click, select add trend line. Okay, in this add trend line, go for linear, then select equation on chart, display R square value. It displays here, right? Now, based on this past data, you see, interpolation and extrapolation I'm estimating. Based on this data, I'm estimating future values. Okay, suppose the temperature is 105. What is water consumption? How can I fit a model? You see, you substitute in this mathematical model, right? Right? So in this mathematical model, instead of x here, you substitute 105, you will get the y value. So water consumption is y, x is temperature. So now I am substituting here, you see, equal to, right? What is the coefficient value here? 1.4512 1.4512. Okay, into x. What is your x at present here?
105.
Right? So minus, now I'm writing mathematical model. Minus 96.845. You see, this is the mathematical model. So ax plus b, actually. Either it is minus, you can type minus, or plus, you can type plus. So now you plus the enter key. So what is my answer here? Right? So my answer is 55.531. So your water consumption is 55. Next, you say any one number?
120.
Okay. Right? So simple. Equal to, right? 1.4512 into
120.
Just I am typing or I am typing the cell address. Or you take 120 minus
96.845.
You see, so my water consumption is what?
77.29.
Okay, suppose here 135, right, 150 also, but need not to type again and again. Once you write a formula, it is very simple. You see, just you drag it, automatically the answers will appear. So you see, now this is what, up to this what? Up to this observed values, but these are all what?
Estimated.
Expected values. You would estimate based on the mathematical model. Now all values, whether your model is good fit or not. Your model manchida kada, good fit or not. You can estimate all the values. Here, expected values, you can estimate it. Okay. But how we estimate the expected values? Just to write a formula equal to, what is its formula? 1.4512. Into, I'm giving cell address instead of 75. First value is 75 in the temperature. I'm typing, clicking here. So its address is A2, bracket close, into, right, minus. What is its value? 96.845. You see, once just I type. Okay, then just you drag here, place the pointer, mouse pointer, bottom of the right corner, just to drag it. Oh, just a moment. What will happen? 1.4512 into A2 into 96.845. Right, anything is wrong here? Just see the formula. 1.4512 into this minus 96.845. Oh, I've taken a bracket extra. Okay. Now, so actually the estimated value is what? 11 point, right? You see, these are all the estimated values. You see? Okay. This is observed and these are all expected. 55, this is 77. If the temperature is 135, the water consumption is 99, right? This is 150, 120. Okay, this is extrapolation. These values are extrapolation. Okay, so outer also you can estimate it. Suppose here the water consumption, what is the temperature is 70. What is the water consumption? Just you drag it. Need not to worry, just you drag. So your water consumption is only 4.739. So how you developed this mathematical model? based on the yellow shaded data. This is based on the yellow data. I developed a one mathematical model, just applied. So this is a correlation and regression analysis. So regression purpose is this, right? Now I am moving t-test, right? So this is regression analysis. Same, you see, okay, calorie consumption versus weight change. So calorie consumption is increasing. What about the weight change? Okay, simple, you see the mathematical model, right? Control C, right? Go to Excel, isn't it? Just Control V, right? So what can you do? Select the data, right? Insert, then scatter plot, right? Within a fraction of a second, you see the data have some up and downs, right? Some, this is a scattered data. So you see the correlation value, add trend line. So linear, go for equation and display R square value. So here the R square value is how much? Just you see.
0.41.
Right? So that means what? 0.41 into 100. So only this model is 41%. Why? It's not a straight line. So these points should be nearer to the straight line, then only this R square value will increase. So this is the regression analysis, right? Okay. But how we take a mathematical model, right? Here you see, this is exponential model, y equal to a into b power x. This is a linear model, y equal to x plus b. This is log linear. This is parabola. This is power curve. But which model we have to select? So that model is depending on shape of a curve. You see, the curve, you draw the scatter plot. If the curve is like this, right? You see the orange line. If the curve is like this, you go for exponential. If curve is a straight line, you go for linear. If the curve is like this, you go for logarithmic. If curve is polynomial like this, okay. So now you see that simple example, what I said. So here I taken the regression analysis, right? Now I am taking, set is it linear. Now I am taking exponential, you see, exponential. Add a trend line. Right, so now I am taking logarithmic, display equation and R square, you see. This is logarithmic. What is R square value here now?
0.4.
What is R square logarithmic? 46, isn't it? This is, and you multiply by 100, 46.8, this is 41. One more mathematical model I am taking. So add trend line. Okay, so polynomial, second degree I am taking, right? Equation, you see, this is polynomial. R square is how much?
51 plus.
51, you multiply by 100. Next, one more model I am taking. Okay. Let us see. So among all, this is the linear one. Linear one is how much? 41. Okay. This is parabola is 51. Okay. Logarithmic is 46. Among all these three models, which model is better? How can you take a decision for this type of model? Generally, the researchers are taking linear model. No, linear model always won't give the full information. How in the sense? So you observe the R square value, which R square, this is a thumb rule, which R square value is maximum, that model is good fit for your analysis. So here 51% high impact is there. So for this type of data, you go for second degree parabola. It gives good estimates. So this is, we call it as a criteria for model selection. Which model you have to apply in your research, in your theory, whether linear model, parabola, or exponential, okay, based on this, which R square value is high, that is better. So this is simply correlation and regression analysis, right? So up to this, any queries? Now I'm moving t-test, f-test, ANOVA. These three, I will close it.
It's great, sir. You can move ahead, please.
Yeah, thank you. Right. Now we go for hypothesis testing, right? So hypothesis testing in the sense, sometimes it is not possible to test all the observations in the population. Okay, nowadays we see at present we are facing the problem is COVID. Okay, but initially the preparation of vaccination is not possible. And also we don't know what are the total number of affected persons. So only few observations we collected. That few observations is sample. That sample we taken as a random samples. Okay, so hypothesis in the sense statistical statement about your population. Okay, for example, you see heartbeat pulse rate per minute is 72. I know that 72 is what population mean. Already I know, but really that population mean may beat 72 or not. You go to the field, gather the 20 observations, you compare these sample mean to the population mean. If both are equal, then you decide that sample mean is equal to the population mean. But sometimes population characteristics may not known. I don't know the heartbeat percentage 72, but we can test based on the hypothesis. Just to take a sample of observations, then you estimate it. Okay, so that is what is out of these population. Just I drawn a few observations. I taken only two observations. The mean is 20. But when we accept your hypothesis, right? I believe the population mean score is 20, right? So reject the hypothesis if not close, right? Your sample values is not close to the population mean, you reject your null hypothesis. Otherwise you accept it. So always your heartbeat pulse rate, your sample mean should be nearer to the 72. Then only you can accept it. Otherwise you reject it. But that a testing of hypothesis, nearly we apply t-test, f-test and ANOVA. When we apply t-test in the sense, if two variables are independent, in the correlation analysis is how one is independent, another one is dependent. But in the t-test, two variables should be independent. Suppose you take male's heartbeat pulse rate and female's heartbeat pulse rate. So male's heartbeat pulse rate may not depending on female's heartbeat pulse rate, both are independent. So at that time, is there any significance difference between male's heartbeat pulse rate and female's heartbeat pulse rate? Go for t-test. You see here, this is the t-test. T-test is used to test sample means, test. Okay, that is, again, t-tests are three types. One sample t-test, two sample t-test, and three paired sample t-test. Paired in the sense, before treatment, after treatment. Okay, single sample t-test means already we know the population characteristic, already we know heartbeat pulse rate, then we test whether the sample, your collected sample, is nearer to the population sample or not. So this is the t-test. Just I will show one example just to go through that. In a pharmaceutical company, an investigator collect samples of 12 tablets of measure the dissolution rate of a drug. But here we can find whether the mean of a dissolution rate is significant to our target dissolution rate or not. So target in the sense here, the population characteristic target, already we know that it is 365, but a researcher collects the sample data. That sample data are this. Okay, now I am analyzing this. So my question is, what these sample are drawn from the same population or not? So the sample mean and the population mean are both are equal or not? Okay, so now we are going to take, just to see here, and now I'm taking one there. Just to paste and control C. Right, so this is the data, right? Right, so these data I entered into the SPSS, statistical package for social sciences. Right, here. Just a moment, it will open. Actually, this is a licensed version in our department. We purchased SPSS 27th version for 20 users. Its cost is 2.7 lakhs, right, under DST. What is that? SAP program. We purchased this SPSS. But it is very useful. Why I explained the analysis in Excel in the sense, but Excel is available anywhere, right? Even in internet center also is available.
Excuse
right?
me.
Yeah.
So do you want to have any small break for 5 minutes, or is it okay? Please have a 5 minutes gap, please.
But I will take 10 minutes, madam. Why means actually my examination is going on.
Sure, sir.
5 o'clock, I have to receive a paper.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
May I start after?
Okay, sir. So let's have a small break here and we rejoin at sharp 5:10 and we'll
5:10, ma'am.
OPSS.
Okay, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Sushma, you can go for the general announcements for the delegates.
Yes, ma'am. Dear participants, we'll have a short break and we'll come back again at 5:10 p.m. In the meantime, I would like to announce some points. So, the feedback link for these two sessions will be sent after the completion of this session. So the feedback link will be posted here in the chat box, and to the YouTube viewers also, we would be posting into the chat box of the YouTube live. So all the participants are requested to please fill the feedback and send it as early as possible. And the common problems we are facing, I would like to inform all participants. Like without giving the feedback form, we are unable to issue the certificates to participants. So if you fill the feedback form, the name would be system generated into our responses, and the same names will be given for the issue of certificates. So please kindly note, all the participants do fill the feedback form and resend us, so that your certificate would be issued within a week time. And we request all the participants to cooperate with us for the issue of certificates. For every webinar, we are issuing the certificates without any fail to any of the participants. So if any issue is there also, we are sorting out within a week. So please let us give a time of 1 week for issue of certificates, because we were into a run into the next series of webinars. We are into a tight schedule, so the delay of certificates is happening. So kindly note this point. And if any of the suggestions or if any of participants want to share with us you are most welcome to talk with us. You are most welcome. You can also share your views, or you can also ask for the session of webinar on which topic you require. So our convener madam is there here. So we truly want to hear from you. Any of our participants,
any faculty member or scholars from the delegates, to kindly please speak up. The situation has come to talk with me straight. You can suggest for further sessions. You can suggest, or at least I think we are eligible for the appreciation. So anybody, you can please. I think a couple of the delegates, they are faculty members in private colleges. I request, if any teacher is there, you kindly respond.
Professor MVV Chandana Lakshmi madam.
Yeah.
Ma'am, can we hear from you, ma'am?
Madam, maatladandi Chandana madam. So I think madam has some technical issues. You can see for any other person.
Yes, ma'am. So students also, we are, I think we are having our MPharm students, any of the research scholars, and you can raise your hand or you can unmute yourself and you can share your views.
Pratyusha.
Yes, Pratyusha, you can. Ma'am, you can just unmute yourself and you can talk, ma'am. Pratyusha, we are unable to hear your voice, ma'am.
Yeah. Good afternoon, ma'am. I am Pratyusha Segu from the Oxford College of Pharmacy. Am I audible to you?
Yes, ma'am, but echo
yes,
is coming. I think you have joined the session twice. So can you just please check your system?
Yeah. One
now
minute,
it's
ma'am.
Clear, ma'am. Now it's clear. You can.
Okay. From morning onwards, I'm hearing both the sessions are very nice. Thank you for presenting such a valuable sessions. And I got so many new things from these sessions. And what else to tell? Yeah, ma'am. Biostats and also IPR, very new techniques. I also published one patent recently in diabetes. And we got a new topics, like so much knowledge I got from a morning. Thank you very much, ma'am. Thank you very much for valuable sessions and this time for us giving your valuable sessions. That's all, ma'am. That's all I can say. Thank you very much.
Can I see you if you do not have any issues?
Yeah, actually, yeah, you can see me, but my kid is there with me.
No problem. It's most welcome.
Okay, fine, ma'am. Definitely.
Additional delegate for our webinar.
Okay, fine, ma'am. Fine, thank you. 1 minute, ma'am. Be in a line. I will
Yeah, sure.
On my video.
Yeah, we'll wait.
Ma'am, I think we can have a small game. Ma'am, shall we have a small game time?
If anybody wants, can take a break. But meanwhile, if anybody wants to talk with us, let us utilize this time.
Yeah, Pava ma'am, I am Pratyusha Segu from the Oxford College of Pharmacy, Bangalore. Yeah, hello ma'am.
Hello.
Yeah, hi.
Ma'am, we ask you to suggest if any further sessions also.
Yeah, ma'am, definitely, definitely.
Like, we wish to hear from you, like, on what topics our next sessions you expect from us.
Okay. Ma'am, any novel...
analysis, preferably.
Yes. Analysis, sir.
Yes.
Yeah, ma'am. Now, actually, we are doing our research work on HRLCMS. We carried out our PhD work. And I like to suggest to give more about HRLCMS. Means most probably, most of them, they are not doing under that. Better we will go analytical part like that.
Okay, yes, sure.
Ma'am. Sure.
Yeah. I'm noting your point, and definitely we will try to contact some expert in the field.
Yes, ma'am. Definitely. Yes.
Yes.
Ma'am. Yes, thank you. Ma'am, feedback form now it will come or we'll send by mail?
No, ma'am, at the end of the session, we'll be giving in the chat box, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Any other sessions are there still?
No, yes, ma'am. Still for today.
For today? Yeah, ma'am, you can carry on. Power, ma'am.
Yeah, it's okay. It is the last session of today's webinar, ma'am. We'll stop here with this biostatistics topic.
Okay.
We'll meet in the next month for with some other topics.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, and one more thing, we want all the sessions PPTs, ma'am, because yes, it is very valuable sessions. Yeah.
We will definitely share. Today we will take from the speakers, and I think along with the certificate, you can get your data.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you very much. Thank you for giving this opportunity to me, Power, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, nice to meet you too, ma'am. Thank you.
Pratyusha, ma'am, we request to circulate all our webinar sessions in your professional contact.
Definitely. And definitely, I will circulate it. Yeah.
And so that we'll have a good group and all will be benefited, ma'am.
Yes, 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 ma'am. Definitely, we'll circulate. We'll make a group. Actually, I try to join in WhatsApp group, but already it is filled up. That's why I can't join.
We had a full group, ma'am, and we are planning to create a second WhatsApp group for these coming webinars. We'll do it today and we'll make you join there, ma'am. In that.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I know Telugu, actually.
Oh, yeah.
I'm from Andhra only. Andhra Pradesh only, ma'am.
So that you have to grab all the Bangalore students to here into our
webinar. Yes, definitely. Definitely. I'll forward as my best. Whatever PPTs you will forward, I'll forward in my college and all over surroundings of Bangalore.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Thank you so much, madam. I'll be next to the webinar. Kaluddam.
Yes, ma'am. Kaluddam, ma'am. Thank you.
Yes, sure. Yes, sure.
Yeah, ma'am.
Right. Hello.
Bye.
Yes, participants.
At least you take it as an inspirational, delegate. So kindly, I request any other member to please join and let's talk. Let us utilize this 15 minutes break really for the sake of webinars, and you can express yourself, either it is positive or negative. We are ready to hear from you. We will definitely rectify if somewhere is something wrong, and if it is a positive, it gives us a lot of energy to move for more further. Students,
I think students will be activated if we give some game time for them, ma'am.
Yeah, why don't you utilize?
Yeah, yes, ma'am.
Let's do something.
Dear participants, are you ready for a small game? Yes. If yes, I can see thumbs up in the chat box.
Yeah.
So I'll just give a question. You can immediately come into a video mode and you can play the game. It is very simple. After I start the game, you say it's very simple game. Yes, ma'am. Shall we proceed, ma'am? Power, ma'am.
Yes, most welcome, Sushma.
So a boy in our participants with Titan watch. You can just on your video and show us. A boy with a Titan watch on your hand. Any of the boy with a Titan watch. You can just show your hand. You can just on the video and show your hand. Boys.
No, so lots of perks will be there for you.
No one is interested, I think.
No, we don't want to see you, but we just want to see your watch.
Yes.
If at all you are shy to show your face. It's just a trial to make the moment light.
Yes.
We have been in the webinar from the morning. So we just
we'll give a chance to girls, ma'am.
Yeah.
I think everyone is ready with their watches now. Okay, and any of the girls,
you're increasing my curiosity.
Any of the girls with a nose pin? Any of the girls with a nose pin? I think we can rarely see, ma'am. That's why I'm just asking the rare questions.
And they would be waiting for the Titan watch.
Yes, ma'am.
Why don't you ask the same question to girls too?
No, ma'am. According to IPR, it's not acceptable.
You cannot patent it.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
We want to hear from our participants. Our university students are there. Our department M.Pharm students are there.
Research scholars,
yes, ma'am. No one?
Ma, it's me, your teacher only. You can please talk to us.
Okay, shall we move to other question? I think this
somebody raised their hand, I think. See in the chat box.
No, ma'am, no one raised their hand.
Okay, then fine. Sushma, let us give a 5 minutes break to them.
Yes, ma'am.
We'll rejoin at 5:10 sharp.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you all.